Live, Dre! Live, my boy! Where are you, dude? Have you help for you, my dude? I'm dying though myself. I don't know what's happening. I'm at the spot! I'm trying to heal you, bro! Press BM. Get the f*** out of here, what? No, try! No! No, try, please! Okay, dude. I think that's gotta be LG.
What's up, YouTube? I just want to say thank you guys for, we're almost at 500 subscribers. I can't even tell you how much that means to me. Over the last year, I've been working as an FPS coach for an esports academy. And, you know, I was busting my ass. I was working long hours. My boss didn't appreciate me at all. He completely overlooked and underplayed my role there. And, you know, we got into an argument and, you know, towards the end and about where the business was going and my role in it. So I said, hey, listen, I really want to get into content creation. Let me teach myself how to make YouTube videos. And, you know, he shot me down and he was like, no. And eventually he forced me out. I mean, sometimes in life you learn some hard lessons and, you know, but something that about me is that's never going to change is I'm always, always going to give 100% in the things that I do. And just my channel growing at the rate that it is just proves that, you know, he was wrong. And that, you know, I could do what I said I was going to do, right? I was going to try and make YouTube videos and here I am doing it. So thank you guys for that. So if you see my videos and if you gain value in any way, you're not subscribed, just do me a favor, just hit that sub button right now. You know, since my first video, I've been teaching myself how to make these videos and I've been getting absolutely farmed in Premiere Pro, like, you know, but I enjoy it. It's a learning process and I've learned a lot of things that, you know, you guys like to see and, you know, I'm going to strive to, continue to put out that type of content. And so today I am posting this video because I am worried. I've been worried for a long time about Devastation. And for those of you who don't know, I played Devastation pretty much since day one on the beta. And, you know, right away I could tell, like, there were some glaring issues with the class and how it functioned in arena because I'm an arena player. And, you know, so, but I was optimistic, you know, so I set up my action bars. You know, I read all the tooltips, all the talents, and, you know, I started theory crafting and I started having fun with it, right? So, you know, as I was doing like duels and skirms and solo shuffles, you know, I noticed that like a few key aspects of the class just like either had to be reworked entirely or at least altered in a way that would bring them up to speed with, you know, classes that have been designed over the last, you know, 15 years. You know, so I did whatever you like good boy would do and who got a beta invite. And I went to the forums and I wrote essays, you know, in a respectful manner with my suggestions on how to improve the class. And I mean, let me tell you, the individuals that posted on the forum for Evoker feedback had so many interesting and unique ideas that like it actually blew my mind, like how creative some of these people were. Like it to the point where it actually changed my perspective of like the random average WoW player, right? Because most of the time you're thinking like, oh, this person's like, you know, whatever, they're not good and they're just, you know, whatever, here doing farming mobs for whatever their cosmetics and like, but no, like there is a ton of really creative people and people who have put so much time and energy into the feedback of the class that it just all went ignored. There was like 4,000 comments nearly on the feedback forum for Evoker, all with the same theme, all with the same concepts, same things that have been brought up time and time again. And there was just literal radio silence from the developers. And so I was even, you know, I mean, not to be like toxic or whatever, but like I was responding to people like, oh, welcome to our weekly sermon where we talk about these issues that are just go ignored next time on Tuesday or what, you know, it's like, but that's neither here nor there. So, I just want to talk about some things that I've seen. I mean, I've played this class so extensively, you know, to the moon and back and all sorts of combinations with all the gear sets and everything. And, you know, so I just want to talk about a couple of things that I feel that the class really needs to be in line with other specs. And anything that you guys have for ideas, please leave it in the comments below. Also, if anybody played like Demon Hunter or DK, when it first came out, that has like insight to how that process all went down. That would be like helpful for me because I didn't actually play in those expansions. I played in BC and then I went to the army, so I didn't come back until WoD, so I missed all of that. I played Legion, but I didn't play Demon Hunter, so I really wasn't really paying attention to like how it was like developing over time, so if anybody has any insight into that, just leave it in the comments because I'd be definitely eager to see what that was like for you guys. All right, so first thing that we're going to touch on is defensives. So I'm sure you've been experiencing over the last, I don't know, 2, 3 weeks that you just died at one corruption dot. I really truly fear that either Obsidian Scales is not coded properly or Renewing Blaze is just not coded properly. I mean, sometimes Renewing Blaze it works, and then other times it doesn't. It's just so inconsistent, right? And so originally when this was being talked about on the forums and people were saying, listen, I'm dying, I can't even survive through wall, like what is this? And then they just went ahead and slapped another charge on the talent tree. Like, to me, that's not really a fix, right? To me, that's just a, oh, hey, here's something for a little bit while we work on some other things. But yeah, so I'm just gonna get right into it, as far as what I truly feel this spec needs. So up front, it needs, as the hero class, you need some sort of like hard CC. Like, I feel like there's no excuse for that type of developer's standpoint. Even Demon Hunter has a ranged stun, like and a ranged kick. And so does DK. DK has a ranged stun. And then we have Sleepwalk, which is a 15 second CD, which makes no sense really because like Sheep is spammable, Fear is spammable, right? If you're gonna create a mage type class, and you're gonna gear it towards more of a control type class, then you have to have some sort of spammable CC. That's just my take on it. This root here for Landslide, I mean, on a minute cooldown, like it just doesn't make any sense. Frost Nova's on a 30 second cooldown, Psychic Scream 30 second cooldown, Hodge, 25 second cooldown. They're all short cooldowns, like around 30 seconds. I know Hodge and Fear are different things, but they're pretty much in line with CC and utility for the respective classes, right? What I will say that these the developers did well in this class is they got the damage right because I'm doing a ton of damage. I got people, I'm playing against like my games at N3s. Like after the first day, I ended like rank 30 on ladder and number one evoker. I know it's only one day, but still, like, but I mean, like all of my games, like because we're jumping MMR so high or so quickly, like all of my games, I'm going against like people who have made skill cap videos, multi rank ones, just every other game. I'm playing like the most elite players that WoW has had over the past like 10 years, and I'm like still winning games, right? I'm not winning every single game, but I'm still winning games, And as I'm playing, I see that yes, the damage is fine. The toolkit or the way that the damage functions for the specialization is still not where it needs to be, I feel, but I think it's a good start. But the reason why I made this video is because like there has been like no, if at any at all, communication from Blizzard on this. And the most recent changes that are I guess like meaningful was they buffed or nerfed Ancient Flame. They reduced the GCD on it, but you can only spam or you can only cast like five Living Flames before your Oom, right? And so I don't really see the reason behind that. I'm still dying through five Living Flames and my walls anyway, so like what is the difference, right? But yeah, and then obviously the Fire Breath nerf, rank 4, 30% up front, they They hear all the people on the forums. They see, oh my god, I'm dying instantly. Never evokers. What's happening? I can't believe this is a real thing. You know, it's not fun. Blah, 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 blah. And so, yeah, they make a change on it. But I'll tell you firsthand. Like, I was there, man. I was there on the forums. 4,000 comments. And, like, there wasn't even a recognition post from the developers about how they have received the feedback. There was a bullshit one, but there wasn't like, okay, we see what's happening with this, blah, 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 blah. The only one that I found was that, oh, we're not changing hover. You can't cast it while casting. We're not removing the 25-yard restriction. And that's it. Like, but there's so many other things that need help. It's just wild to me because, like, every other class got all of these, you know, developers saying, hey, we hear you, you know, here's what our intentions are moving forward. But, like, Evoker is nothing. And that just blows my mind because it's supposed to be the hero class. And they just dropped the ball in it. Like, this is the lowest played spec in the game. Even me. Like, you know, two times Gladiator, I got a 2.7 achieve. Like, I can't even get into twos matches in LFG applying because they're like, oh my god, Devastation, no, I don't want to see it. You know, like, people don't want to play with something that's bad, right? They have, in their mind, a less of a chance to win, you know? And so, I mean, I can only imagine what's happening on the PvE side. I don't do PvE, but, you know, I looked at the numbers a little bit on Wowhead and, like, it's doing, like, okay. It's, like, mid-tier on the numbers. But, like, still, people are complaining. Like, listen, 25 yards is not working. And I'll tell you right now, 25 yards in arena is not working. I could make it work with Disintegrate, Empire, and the Empowered spells. I could do that. Kick, Quell, I can't. Not 40. It has to be 40. Azure Strike also has to be 40. I will never, against a good rogue, ever be able to get combat, never. He'll always be able to shadow step, sap me, and he will always have a guaranteed opener no matter what happens. Unless there's like the really small percentage chance that I throw a root out and I just manage to land him, but that's like not guaranteed, right? And even then, like, he's going to be all over me with two shadow steps, secret technique, whatever, it's shadow strike, he's on me, right? So there's no counterplay there, but, you know, there's nothing from Blizzard on that either. But what I would like to see is, you know, there was a big change or a big communication post yesterday regarding like boomy talents and all that stuff. And like, that's a step in the right direction. But like, for me, that kind of communication, it seems to come from like out of left field. Like, it's not like, hey, Druids, we hear you, you know, we're actively monitoring this and we're going to get back to you soon. Just be patient with us. Like, I would rather that than just radio silence. And all of a sudden now you nerf Ancient Flame mana cost. Like, it just doesn't make any sense. And so, I would definitely be, curious to see what you guys have to say in the comments. And again, if you played DK or DH when it first came out, you know, I'd love to hear how your experience was with that, how the class progress with you know, its talents, its abilities, and all that good stuff. So you know, because this is the first time for me that I've had a chance to actually play a new class on the launch of an expansion. And you know, while I am making it work to a degree, you know, it's very clear that some things are going to have to change in order for this to not be a complete and total flop. So if you did enjoy this video, please hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. We're almost at 500 followers, and I'm streaming nightly on my Twitch. So I'll leave the link for that in the description, where you can see me bash my face against the keyboard trying to play games against like Rep Warriors and actual good classes as this spec. So, yep, that's it for now. Thank you guys again for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take a L no more. Never take a damn thing slow.
All I know is trace this dough.